getting the U.S. government on the road to fiscal health through spending cuts and lowering our national debt. That's our topic for the next 5 minutes. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Comcast Newsmakers. I'm Robert Tranum. As always, thank you very much for joining us. And joining me is Representative Bill Huizenga, Republican from Michigan. But you know, Congressman, before we talk about the fiscal health of this country, I think we should talk about some personal health. You're wearing an orange ribbon. What is that all about?
Yeah, I am. This is a ribbon I've been wearing in honor of a young man named Wes Leonard from Fenville, Michigan. Wes has gotten a lot of press, and what happened with him is he made the winning shot, the high school basketball game, and unfortunately had cardiac arrest and passed away shortly after that. And so it's fair to say I think the whole nation's been Blackhawks fans for the last few weeks, and unfortunately they ended their run, but I know that Wes's family appreciates all the thoughts and prayers that have been coming from literally around the country, and there's almost not a single person who asks me about this ribbon when I tell them they know about Wes and the story. And so as I told the young men in the locker room right before their first game, character is about how you respond to adversity, and they've responded well, and we just hope and pray that they're going to continue to respond that way. But we appreciate you asking.
Unbelievable story, and of course our thoughts are with the family. Now, let me gingerly transition to the overall fiscal health of this country. Yeah. I think most Americans can all agree that unfortunately we're a little bit on shaky ground here. Walk us through this.
Yeah, we're on very shaky ground, and it's not so much even about you and I, Robert. It's about our kids and our grandkids that we haven't even necessarily met yet. That's really what motivated me to run. My five kids, I have five young children, but looking at what sort of debt we are amassing for them and the hole that we are digging, it's not fair to them. So we've got to make sure that we are maintaining essential services here with the government that we've got. I think it's fair to say that whether it's at the local, state, or federal level, there's a fundamental conversation that we are having as a nation about the role of government and what does that mean. And from my perspective, bottom line is we can't keep putting it on the national credit card. It's time to cut it up.
Congressman, your Democratic colleagues would say, look, we're all about cutting the deficit as well, but you know, in order to have a serious conversation about cutting the debt, we need to talk about Social Security. We need to talk about entitlement reform, and we also need to talk about defense, which is, of course, the holy grail on the Republican side. At least that's what some would say. What is your response to that?
Well, first of all, with defense, I think that's changing in many ways. I think you're hearing more and more voices say we've got to put everything on the table and examine
including
that,
defense.
Including defense. I was one of those people that voted against the second engine for the F-35, for example, with a facility in my district that supplied some parts.
Which could mean less jobs in your district.
It potentially means that there's more challenge with that, but I felt very strongly that I needed to put my vote where my mouth is, and that's something that I've been talking about, and I committed to them that we'll be working hard to make sure that there are other areas that they can expand into. But ultimately, it's about job creation and paychecks. We have to make sure that we can get people back to work. Michigan's been hit like none other over the past decade, but we've got to get people back to work, and we do that not just through taxation, it's also the regulatory environment, and it's about government saying, yes, we're going to help you as a business or as an individual, an entrepreneur, rather than say, we're going to put a few barriers up. But I do want to get back to I want to get back to the spending on Social Security and Medicare and Medicaid. If you look, those are the three major issues that we are dealing with that are driving so much of our debt. And I think it's Pollyannish to think that we aren't going to have to deal with them. Question is who are we going to deal with that about? And it's more for people like you and myself and our kids. It's not those that are currently accessing the system or are soon to be accessing the system. We do have to protect it for them, but we do need to change the way we're doing
it. We have about 30 seconds left, Congressman. There are a lot of folks in this town in Washington, D.C. that says you can't turn your back on the vulnerable. You can't turn your back on the elderly and those who are living paycheck to paycheck. 25 seconds. What is your response to that?
No, you're absolutely right. But it shouldn't just be the government that's expected to do that. I, as an individual, I need to lead that charge, and within my church, within my community, and that's really the key.
All right. Thank you very much, and of course, thank you for watching Comcast Newsmakers. Have a great day, everybody. We'll see you next time. Take care.